Hello friends, I'm your Ram Singh, present again with new topic which is related to the climate, and this topic related to the geography and topic of geography. So in this we'll study about climate of India, difference of weather, all these and the factors which are affecting to the climate. Let us start without wasting time. First of all, you may have seen every day or after some days, sometime you feel very sunny day or sometime you feel cloudy day and sometime you feel windy day. Means these all are changing phenomenons are striking to the mind to think about these things. What are these? So what is difference there? There are two words, climate and weather. First of all, the need to understand the difference between these two words, that is climate and weather. What is the meaning of climate and what is the meaning of weather? Let us understand it. What is the difference there? First of all, climate means it refers to the sum total of weather conditions and variations over a large time, over a long period of time or large area, means bada area hai aur lamba time hai, usde which we are going to count sum total of weather conditions. The weather conditions means ke us samay de vich, us particular area de vich keho jiyan climatic conditions ya keho jiyan weather conditions jehdiyan hegiyan continuously rehndiyan hegiyan ne. So this is called climate, means the total or sum total of weather conditions over a large area and long period of time. Lambe samay de vich means ke 30 saal 35 saal tak ude liye weather conditions aundiyan ne, that is the type of climate. And now weather means it refers to state of atmosphere over an area at any time. Kisi time, as I discussed in the starting of this video, that sometime we feel very windy, sunny or cloudy day, or sometime we feel raining outside, right? So these all are the conditions, means weather conditions. So it is a state of atmosphere for a short period of time over a small area. So now some of the elements of weather, those are temperature, atmospheric pressure, wind, humidity, precipitation. These all are the elements which are included in weather. Weather is part of climate. Climate is very big term which is covering a large area or long time, right? So the weather is part of climate. So only the difference, it is not a big difference of conditions. There is the sum total of conditions over a long period of time, and here very small time, means for 1 hour or for half day, means that time of period, what kind of weather conditions or atmospheric conditions or state of atmospheric is facing, that is called the weather of that particular time. Now next, if we talk about, you may have observed that weather conditions fluctuate very often even within a day, but there is some common pattern over a few weeks or months. Days are cool or not, or hot, it may be hot, windy or calm, cloudy, bright, wet or dry. On the basis of the generalized monthly atmospheric conditions, the years is divided into seasons such as winter, summer and rainy season. So these are the seasons, means a particular time of period which in which that particular time we feel winter, means we feel cold, that is called winter, and we feel hot, that is called summer, and we feel rain outside, that is called rainy outside. And the world is divided into number of climatic regions. Do you know what type of climatic India has, why it is so? Let us know discuss about the climatic type of India. The climate of India is described as monsoon type. So the climatic conditions of India, these are monsoon. In Asia, this type of climate is found mainly in the south. In Asia, this type of climate is found mainly in south and the southeast. So this type of climate is found in the Asia's these areas. Now let us discuss about precipitation. Precipitation means falling of water from the sky. That is called precipitation in any condition, right? There are various variations not only in the form of and types of precipitation but also in its amount and the seasonal distribution. While precipitation is mostly in the form of snowfall in the upper parts of Himalaya, rains over the rest of the country, or annual precipitation varies from 400 cm in Meghalaya to less than 10 cm in Ladakh and western Rajasthan. So most parts of country receive rainfall from June to September. So these are the, and next we discuss about the temperature conditions. Temperature conditions, coastal areas experience less contrast in temperature conditions. Seasonal contrasts are more in the interior of the country. There is decrease in rainfall generally from east to west. In the northern plains, these variations have given rise to variety of lives of people in terms of food they eat, the clothes they wear, and also the kind of houses they live in. Next is climatic controls. Climatic controls. There are six major controls of climate of any place. Those are latitude, altitude, pressure and wind system, distance from sea, ocean currents, and relief features. Due to curvature of Earth, the amount of solar energy received varies according to latitude. So the receiving of the sunlight, that varies, means on the equator it will be very high or direct, but whenever you move toward the polar areas it reduces, means due to curvature, means jo earth hai wo curvature hai, means gol hai, curve bani hui hai. So is karke heat jo hai usde vich jehdi hegi ah vary kardi hegi hai. And after that, as a result, air temperature generally decreases from the equator towards the poles, as I discussed earlier. As one goes from the surface of Earth to higher altitudes, the atmosphere becomes less dense and the temperature decreases. The hills are therefore cooler during summers. It is the fact, the summers feel the hills feel very cool temperature. The pressure and wind system of any area depend on the latitude and altitude of place. Thus it influences the temperature and rainfall pattern. Next is distance from the sea. So as you know, the sea affects or influences decrease and the temperature decrease due to water or the effect of the water. It moderating influences decreases and people experience extreme weather conditions. This condition is known as continentality. Ocean currents. Ocean currents, as you studied in the previous classes, or those have two types, cold ocean currents and warm ocean currents. It is the very simple to understand. Wherever warm ocean current will go, that area will become warm or hot. Wherever cold ocean current will go, that area will experience cold type of temperature. Now finally, relief to play a major role in determining the climatic climate of the place. High mountains act as barriers or cold or hot winds. They may also cause precipitation. So due to relief, as you know that Himalayan is there in the northern part of India. So Himalayas are having a very big or very important role in the climatic conditions of India. Because whenever the monsoon comes from the south of the India, that strikes with the Himalayan mountains and starts raining over the country. And next, that is cold winds are there in the Central Asia. Central Asia is very cold, as you know that the latitude difference is there. So due to that, those cold winds, the Himalayans are there. Himalayans are barrier for those winds, which are stopping them, or which are very big obstacle for those winds. Means those winds are unable to come in the Indian continent, Indian subcontinent, right? So because of that, this area is not having very cold type of climate. Next is factors affecting India's climate. Factors affecting India's climate. Latitude, that is very important here. The Tropic of Cancer passes through the middle of the country from the run of Kutch in the west to Mizoram in the east. Tropic of Cancer belongs to tropical area. So the latitude, as you know that Tropic of Cancer passes through the India, means it divides it into two equal halves. So it affects the climatic type of India. And altitude, India has mountains to the north. Altitude, India has mountains to the north, which have an average height of 6,000 meter. India also has a vast coastal area where the maximum elevation is about 30 meter. So the Himalayas, as I discussed with you, winds from Central Asia from entering the subcontinent. And next one is pressure and winds. Pressure and winds. The climate and associated weather conditions in India are governed by following atmospheric conditions. Pressure and surface winds, upper air circulation, and western cyclonic disturbances and tropical cyclones. So India, in the region of northeasterly winds, these winds originate from the subtropical high pressure belt of the Northern. And after that, the pressure and wind conditions over India are unique. Let us discuss about it. During winter, there is high pressure area north of the Himalayas. Cold dry winds blow from this region to low pressure areas over the oceans to the south. In summer, a low pressure area develops over interior Asia as well as over northwestern India. This causes a complete reversal of the directions of winds during summer. As you can understand that the low pressure area, so there is a very complete reversal of the winds toward the that particular starting area in the summer. Air moves from the high pressure area over the southern India, Indian Ocean, in the southeasterly direction, crosses the equator and turns right toward the low pressure areas over the Indian subcontinent, right? So, and after that, the upper air circulation, that is in this region, dominated by westerly flow. An important component of this flow is the jet stream. These jet streams are located approximately over 27 degree to 30 degree north latitude. Therefore, they are known as subtropical westerly jet streams. Over India, these jet streams blow south of the Himalayas all through the years, except in summer. The western cyclonic disturbances experienced in north and northwestern parts of country are brought in by this westerly flow. In summer, the subtropical westerly jet streams moves north of Himalayas with the apparent movement of the sun. So the apparent movement of sun that also affects to the movement of the winds. An easterly jet stream called the subtropical easterly jet stream blows over peninsular India approximately over 14 degree north during the summer months. Okay, students, see you in next video. Thank you.